Thank you for visiting our channel. Today I came out to review and also quick unbox this brand new remote, which is rechargeable. It's an Air Mouse. It has a built-in mic and also it is backlit. The company behind this remote is called Strqua. It is modeled G7. They are one of the best remote creators yet. You can see that the box is really nicely designed. This remote will work with not only just your Android box, but if you have a Mac PC, if you have Windows, Linux, and also any Android devices, you can connect this. Also, you can use this as a gaming pad. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Make sure you share this with your friends and family and click the notification icon so you will be notified once we have a new video out. Plus, click to click the like button. It really motivates us to make these type of videos quickly for you. If you have a question, drop them at the bottom of the video. We love to help you out ASAP. You can see that the box is really nicely designed. It doesn't have much markings around, but just one side of it indicates what it's going to be compatible with. And in the front, it just says Air Remote Mouse G7. So here's the remote, and we're going to open it now. So here are the components. So it comes with a user manual. You can see that it is just one page that has been folded, kind of like a pamphlet. And it has all the information that you need for this remote itself. One side is in English and the other side is in Mandarin. You can see that it has covered everything. If you need this, ask us at the bottom of the video and we will provide this on our website so you can see it as PDF. It also came with a little wire so you can charge your remote and we will show you how that's done too. It comes with a little dongle. Now this is 2.4 gigahertz dongle. It will transmit all the signals to your box from the remote. We will show you when we connect this to the box. Here's the big moment. The remote itself is sitting inside of a nice plastic. So once you take it out, this is how it looks. I really like the way that they have designed this in the front and also in the back. So we will go from the front. You can see that this part is all made out of plastic, hard plastic, but they have designed it in two different parts. So this part is not shiny. It's really nice. It doesn't grab your fingerprints. So even if you put your finger here, unless it is very moist, it will put your fingerprints on it, except that it does not. So going from the top, you do not have any kind of IR sensors. Going to the sides, it's all going to be cut in different little parts. And it looks like they put a little film on top of it. So that way it is not going to be that shiny, but this part is the shiny part. I really like this design. Going on the bottom is where you're going to be able to charge it. We will show you that in a few seconds. Going on the other side of it, there's nothing there. But going to the front is where you're going to see the light. So when you press the power, since the dongle is not connected, it is going to be blinking. And there is a little part for the mic. And then you have the mute button. Then you have the menu. You have the play and pause, rewind and fast forward is right there. The play and pause is right there. You do have a little part that says IR. I do not know how that's going to function. We will find out in a few seconds. And you do have some little buttons that you can place a programming on it. You have volume up and down, you have page up and down right around the navigation key. And the navigation key is nicely set up, but it doesn't have any markings to say right, left, top and bottom. But the OK button is really nicely done. You can hear it when you press it. Now, going on the bottom part of it, you have the mic button so you can press and talk. You do have the home and also the escape button. I'm not sure why they're always placing it together. And then you have the Air Mouse remote. Now, going on the bottom, you do have the backlit. We will show you in a few seconds at how that will work. And then you do have full numeric buttons through zero. You do have the delete button, which a lot of people like to have. All right, let's capture in the back. Then we will go back into the backlit. So in the back, you have full set keyboard. You have the escape, tap, shift, control, and function. So this way, you have to see the other buttons right on top. I wish they would make it a different color, but again, it's still good. Function is going to make you enable to press these little parts on the top of the buttons that it indicates, like 1, 2, 3, or the question mark, or the plus sign null. You're going to need to press that. Except that the best part is that when you put the function, you can automatically press the three W's, .com. All that is just by pressing that one button. So here is the really nice keyboard, how it really looks. I really like this. So this is how the backlit looks once you have the lights dimmed down or turned off. Now I'm trying to mix two colors so that way it shows up. But once you flip it in the back, it automatically shows you the actual backlit. So it looks really nice. It looks like a laser cut. I really like this type of remotes that only the letters or the actual writings will be lit up. And now you can see these are a little bit better than this part, and some of them are better light than the others. But again, when you flip it back in the front, I really like this. So this way at middle of the night, you will be able to grab your remote and go to your box and use it. All right, so that's not only thing. Let's go through and show you some of these buttons, how it really functions when you are playing with it on the Android box. All right, so grabbing our remote, you can see from the top that if we hold the button for a few seconds, now on the screen, you automatically get the pop-up. So that means this will work using your dongle. So I do not want to forget, you have to make sure that your dongle is connected to the box before you can function or play with this remote itself. So I have already done that. And this is the escape button because I do not want to turn the box off. I will press back so that way it gets out. After that, we wanted to press mute. Now you should see the little bar on the top that says it's muted. Press it again, it's unmute. You can see that the bell icon shows properly. Now the menu keys and everything is really good. If you have inside of some apps, you require to go in and get that. Since I'm not playing with the live TV on this box itself, I'm not gonna be able to press this menu key, but it will work. Here's another part as they play and pause. So if I am going to play a movie, and let's see if this part really works. All right, so we will test this play and pause. Also the rewind or fast forward button. Now remember that this is not just going to zoom through your video. This will totally change your screen from one video to another. So in order to process, we went to YouTube and we're going to select one of these 4K videos. So let's select this one. And you can see that it has a sound, yes. But now in order to pause it, we just have to press the button. And there you go, now it paused. Now if you have to press again play, it will play. Now if we want to mute it for a few seconds, and then we wanted to go to see if possible we can switch a video, we will just press switch, and you can see it working. It's just changing the video to another one. Press again, it will just change again. So it's very nice and steady in order for you to play with this. I'm just going back right now into the old videos, and that's how easy it is to process, and you can press pause, and it will totally pause for you directly from this remote itself, so you do not have to do anything extra with it. And again, the ones on the bottom, you have to program it, and it will only work with the box that you're connected to. Hook this up to something like Netflix. You want to put this up for something like Disney Plus. As soon as you press, it will load for you. So this is, again, it's a really nice and easy buttons for you to play with. All right, so let's see if the mic really works. So we will go to the mic, press OK, and then we're going to allow it. And now, if we have to talk, it should already know what we're looking for. There you go, you see that? So it's typing. This is really cool. So it works inside of your actual YouTube app. And I will go back to the mic. 4K movies. You see that? It automatically just searched for it and it came up. So this is the best part about the mic itself on this. Me just pressing that for a few seconds, it came up. But here is how you're going to be able to volume up or volume down. The page up and page down is really cool if we want to go inside of, if you want to go inside of something like Chrome and you want to go to a website, which we're going to go to our own. So now this is our website, you can see it. And now if we wanted to go up and down, we can hold the mouse itself to go up and down, and sometimes some boxes doesn't allow you, like right now this box does not allow me to hold on one part of the page and go up and down. So there you go. Now once you are here and you're on the main page, you can just press page down or page up. You can see right now that it just makes the page go up and down. That's pretty nice. Now that's not the only thing. So if I press the mouse and then I go back on the top part to type something, let's just turn off the mice and then turn around and try to type something. And then go to triple W, and we're going to say MTV and then function.com automatically there. Now we're gonna go back into that button right there. We will press enter. So now it automatically should take you to that MTV website, which is pretty cool. Now we can turn it back and we can press home to get out of this app itself. And it looks like the home button is not really made for home button. It's a back button until you press it a bunch of times for you to go back to the main screen. So this is how this part is done. I want to mention one more thing. If this is flashing green, that is a really good sign. That means is that your battery is good and you don't need to really charge it. And also the mic button is working. So that's a really cool remote. Now that's not the only thing. If you want to charge this, remember that you do not need a lot of charge, but once in a blue moon you do need to charge it. So grab the wire and make sure that it is positioned properly, as you can see mine right now. And then you have to, it's upside down, and then you have to press it and then hook up the other side to your box or to a USB portal in order for this to get charged. Don't leave it over 2 hours for the charge, so that way it will work. But again, this will last you forever. This is one of the best remotes that I came across yet for me to play with. I really enjoyed playing with this. Links will be available in the bottom where you can order this from. And also, if you need more help about this remote, request at the bottom of this video or our website, which is exitex.info, so we can help you out. Except that, I hope you guys like our video. If you do like it, click the like button, subscribe button on the top, comment in the bottom. Always remember to visit our own website, which is exitex.info. Like us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter, Instagram, and other social networking places. And thank you.